What's up, Chimmers? It's James here, and welcome to a fresh movie review. And tonight's fresh movie review is Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, Tarantino's 9th film. So we've got one more to go, apparently. Like he said he wants to stop at 10. I'm not sure if he actually wants to stop at 10, but hey. Goes for 2 hours and 41 minutes. Fuck, it's long. MA for my Australian viewers, R for you Americans again. It's a lot could be cut, a lot can be cut from this, but so this is what I'm getting, what I'm taking from it. Alternate history. And a faded television actor and his stunt double strive to achieve fame and success in the film industry during the final years of Hollywood's golden age in 1969 Los Angeles, when Charles Manson was huge. Sure, yeah, it takes liberties with that. Hold on. Hello? No, there we go. Oh. Starring Leonardo DiCaprio, Brad Pitt, Margot Robbie. Julia Butters, Timothy Oliphant, Emile Hirsch. I did not recognize Dakota Fanning. Mike Moe as Bruce Lee, and I think he did a really good job as Bruce Lee. but yeah, this takes lots of liberties with history, like alternate history. Also starring Luke Perry in his last role, Al Pacino, Damian Lewis. Oh, that's who it was. I didn't mind it. From the three separate storylines we got, the actor's point of view, the stuntman's point of view, and Margot Robbie's Sharon Tate's point of view, it was good. Like I said, long-winded, a lot of feet focus. Like, everyone had dirty fucking feet. It was like, ew. And I'm like, Tarantino, do we need to see the feet? No, but, when I say alternate history, it's what probably should have happened instead of what actually happened with the, Charles Manson murders. So, and I don't know if this was supposed to give us a history lesson or not, but, I was a bit confused, but that's just me. It was good to, the film that they were creating within the film sounded a bit better, because, the spaghetti westerns and, and Leonardo DiCaprio, he's Rick Dalton trying to act as a bad guy but giving it his all, and it's like, okay, cool. And a lot of cameos too. I was surprised by that. It was like, oh, sweet. it was Leo Dunham. Yeah. But we had Michael Madsen in it. Raymond Willis, Zoe Bell, Kurt Russell, Michael Madsen. I was like, oh, cool. Who else was in there? But everyone acted really well. It was interesting to see. It was actually fucking almost pristine perfect for recreating an old school Hollywood style film. The clothes were on point, the editing of the movies were on point, the historical monuments, well, if you want to call it that, like the historical figure things, like the food, the sceneries and all that was like really, it felt like you were watching a 60s film right now, if it was the 60s itself, if that makes sense. But yeah, and stoned Brad Pitt is always funny, Brad Pitt. and the what happens to the Manson murderers is brutal as fuck, and I enjoyed it. I was like, oh my god! Like I said, when Tarantino does alternate history, it's interesting. It's like, okay, that could work. Austin Butler, who's he? Oh, he's that guy. Okay, sorry. I don't think, no, Tarantino did not star in the movie. But it was historically sweet to watch. I didn't mind it. If it was teaching a history lesson or alternative history lesson, I'm not big on that timeline of what it's supposed to be. Just all I know is Charles Manson is supposed to happen and murders the Polanski family. And it's like, so okie dokie then. So I give it a 7 out of 10. I didn't mind it. It's not, in my personal opinion, it's not Leonardo DiCaprio's best work. It's reasonable. It's... it's a good showing from Brad Pitt. Nice of Emile Hirsch to be in something. And Margot Robbie felt a bit left out, but like, what you gonna do? Yeah, 7 out of 10. If you like fucking long winded movies, go see it. It's really good. I rate it a little bit higher than Inglourious Basterds. But because personally, in my opinion, I'm not a humongous fan of Inglourious Basterds because of the way Hitler dies in it. Like, it'd be sweet if Hitler died in that way. But being that we know how he died, it kind of bums me out. It's like, heh. And again, I don't know a lot about Nazis. And it's like, oh, I'll have 3 when you're supposed to do, I don't know. I'll have 3. When you're supposed to have 3 or something? I don't know. Where does this sit in your Quentin Tarantino line? Like, from 1 to 9, what's this for you? With all his other movies. Like I said, this is above Inglourious Basterds. And possibly above Death Proof. By just a wee bit. Mostly because Death Proof, they have that car scene. It's like, oh, I'm a stunt woman. I'm going to go on top of the car and do that. It's like, why? Just why? But yeah. But again, that's just me. So, 1 to 9, where do you rate this? And for Tarantino's last movie, he said he wants to do something in the realms of horror. Now, we've seen him help out with vampires with From Dusk Till Dawn. Now, and if it was supposed to be his last, how big do you want him to go? Do you want him to go all out like the blood guy's like, oh, it's my time to shine? Or subtle and more psychological horror? Like, share, subscribe, leave a comment. And, thanks, guys.